So when I was getting prepared to write the sermon this week, I was talking with Pastor Dan, and I told him that I wanted to do something different with this reading that we had today. I think the normal sermon on this topic would go something like this. God heals 10 lepers. Only one comes back to thank him, and that one is a Samaritan who's the outcast, the one that doesn't fit in. We are the 9, and we need to be more like the 1. We need to be more thankful to God. And I agree with this wholeheartedly, but it's been done many times before. And I wanted to take this in a different direction. I want to talk about borders. First, I want to spend some time on physical borders. Borders we can see in everyday life around us. In our reading today, Jesus is walking through the region between Samaria and Galilee. And Jesus, all through Scripture, frequents borders between physical regions and countries. In that day, Samaritans were the outcasts of the area. No one wanted to associate with them or have anything to do with them. But yet Jesus heals one, and that one is the one that comes back to thank him. Who are the people that are like this in our lives, in our country, in our community, even right here in our church? Now, there's a large discussion happening in our country today about refugees that are coming in from all over the world, being misplaced from areas, but especially the Middle East. Now, I want to show a video to you of a drone flyover of Homs, Syria. And it looks like something out of a movie, but this is real life. These people have been displaced, killed, tortured by war and destruction by terrible people. What, as Christians, should our response be to this? Now, in our Bible study video series that we're going to be starting this week on Tuesday, there's a section that talks about welcoming people, that we need to be like Christ, and regardless of circumstances or risk, we need to help all people in need. You see, our God is a welcoming God. He welcomes anyone and everyone into his family. During his time on this earth, he welcomed all into his presence or to wherever he was preaching at that time. Now, from Galatians chapter 3, verse 28. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is no male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. And from Romans chapter 15, verse 7. Therefore, welcoming one another as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. And finally, in Matthew chapter 25, verses 35 and 36, for I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you visited me. I was in prison and you came to me. With Jesus as our example, we should never, ever be shy about welcoming others. Wherever they're from, whether it's Syrian refugees into this country, strangers into our church, the needy into our homes for a meal, or just saying hello and smiling to someone on the streets. Let's look again at our reading from Galatians. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is no male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. This verse really shows God's welcoming attitude. This reminder was written to the early church, and it went against their culture to welcome people different from themselves. Does this sound familiar? Just like in today's world, there are some people we might find it hard to welcome based on our cultural expectations. But if we are believers in Christ, then we are the same as they are, and they are the same as we are, and should be welcomed regardless. Our reading from Romans is a blatant reminder about Jesus' welcoming nature. Jesus died for all of us so that we could be welcomed, sinless and reborn, into the presence of God the Father. How can we exclude, deny entry to, or ignore others for our own petty and fear-driven reasons when Jesus gave up his life to make all of us welcome? And finally, the verse from Matthew is probably one of the most well-known verses from the Bible as it concerns welcoming others. It speaks specifically to those who might be initially hard to welcome, the poor, the sick, or anyone who we would consider different. But our kindness is not only a reflection on Christianity as a whole, but it's a direct reflection on how we think of Jesus. Now, when it comes to physical borders in this world, we need to act more like Christ and walk with one foot on either side of the line. Continue to push boundaries and continue to welcome without asking questions and without regrets, especially those that are different than we are. Now, the second border I want to talk about today are those borders that can't be seen, specifically the borders within ourselves. We all have those places that we don't want anybody to see, the ugly places inside of us that we try to hide from the world, whether it's addiction, anger problems, jealousy, lust, self-hate, or any other thing. We try to shove it down and hide it from everyone else, especially God. We find it hard to let God into the places that we are ashamed to show the world, the ugly places in our lives that are the toughest to let God into. That's where we need to let God into most often, so that healing can begin. It doesn't matter what you've done or where you've been or the things that you think are terrible that you continue to do. We need to let God there to help us through. Going through the tough things on our own is just going to tear us down. So instead of being torn down, do the tearing ourselves. Tear down the borders, the barriers, and the walls within ourselves, and let God help and let others help as well. Don't be afraid to lean on others, and especially don't be afraid to lean on God. Pour everything out and let others help you as well. Now, I want to play a song today that's inspired me through the years. It's called Healing Begins by 10th Avenue North.
So you thought you had to keep this up, all the work that you do, so we think that you're good, and we can't believe it's not enough. All the walls you built up are just glass on the outside, so let them fall down. There's freedom waiting in the sound when you let your walls fall to the ground.
I really don't think it can be said any better than that. Can we pray for a second? Lord, we thank you so much for this time that we're able to come together today. And Lord, I just ask that if there are people here that are struggling with something inside themselves that they don't want anybody to see, they don't want anybody to know about, they don't want you to know about, that those borders can be torn down. That those walls can fall and your grace will fill them. Your love will fill them. Lord, continue to work in all of us here. Help us to be accepting of all people, whether it's in our country, or our communities, or right here in this church. Lord, we just thank you for everything you do for us. We thank you for the love you show us. We thank you for the grace that you give us. We thank you for forgiving us through putting your Son on the cross. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.